known as accounting process. So you have already done this bookkeeping and accountancy. ये आपने already किया हुआ है, okay? Accountancy is what you are learning in this year, FY BCom semester 1. Bookkeeping is what you have learned in the last year, okay? Now what exactly is the difference between bookkeeping and accountancy? So I would like to tell you, accountancy includes bookkeeping. I repeat. Accountancy includes bookkeeping. मतलब accountancy is a bigger concept and bookkeeping is a smaller concept. तो जहाँ पे bookkeeping खत्म होता है accountancy वहाँ से शुरू होता है. तो this is a major difference between bookkeeping and accountancy. Now when I am telling you what you learned in 11th standard was bookkeeping. तो bookkeeping means you are just recording. You are just recording your business transactions. That is known as bookkeeping. And accountancy में what you are doing, मतलब bookkeeping में आप क्या करते हो, just recording your transactions, मतलब you are journalizing and posting them into ledger, इसको बोलते हैं bookkeeping, okay? Is this clear? Yeah. And what is accountancy? Accountancy में you go much ahead, you calculate the profit and losses of the company, so that the financial position of the company is known to the end users. Now who are the end users? The company owner, the board of directors, the government, the people who gives you loan, that is the bankers, that is the bank people, and the shareholders who invest in your company. So for so from the point of view of this end users, you maintain your books of records. That is accountancy. Okay, and bookkeeping is just a small word in front of accountancy. Bookkeeping just used with recording of transactions. That's it. Okay, yeah. Am I clear about this difference between bookkeeping and accountancy? समझ में आया? जहाँ पे bookkeeping खत्म होती है, accountancy वहीं से शुरू होती है. Okay? Bookkeeping is just recording your business transactions in a systematic way. That is called as bookkeeping. Whereas accountancy में you record transactions from the objective of estimating its profit or losses for that particular financial. Yeah. Okay. See. Bookkeeping is a process of recording business transactions in the books of accounts in a systematic manner. That is called bookkeeping. Whereas accountancy mein kya hota hai? See, accounting or accountancy is a wider concept than bookkeeping. Bookkeeping mein, accountancy mein what you do? Accountancy mein, you are recording, sorting, summarizing data resulting from business operations and events. So iska kya meaning hota hai? I'll write the meaning of this. Summarizing matlab analysis. I repeat, summarizing means to analyze. So what are you analyzing? The end result. What is the end result of business? Either profit or loss. That is to estimate profit or loss for the business. That is to know the financial position of the business. Okay, so analysis word is missing in bookkeeping. Bookkeeping doesn't do analysis. It just simply records your business transactions. Whereas accountancy mein recording ke baad uska analysis bhi hota hai. That is the difference. Okay. So see the point of difference between bookkeeping and accountancy. So the first point of difference is obviously the meaning itself. So meaning to maine aapko bataya, bookkeeping is what? Just a system, it's a systematic recording of your business transactions. Okay, so it's a process of recording business transactions in a systematic manner. And what is accountancy? It is a process of recording, sorting, and summarizing data resulting from business operation and events. Iska simple word maine aapko bataya, that is to estimate profit and loss in simple language. Okay? Or you can use this meaning also. Ye easy meaning hai. Accountancy also refers to systematic analysis of recorded data. But maine jaisa aapko bataya, simply it means to record and analyze the estimation of profit and loss for that particular company period. Stage. So bookkeeping is the first stage. I told you ना, bookkeeping ends and accountancy starts. तो bookkeeping is the first stage, whereas what do you call, accountancy is the next stage after bookkeeping. Okay, next objective. So when you are talking about the objective of bookkeeping is only one. That is, it provides primary information. Journal ledger, prime basic information. Whereas accountancy aims at, I've been saying this repeatedly, profit and loss, and gives the financial position. Aims at finding the profit and loss and gives the financial position. Financial position मतलब balance sheet. Okay, clear? Profit and loss मतलब P&L account. Then level of work. Bookkeeping is very easy, so it can be done any with any junior staff in your company. Whereas for accountancy, you require an experienced staff. Okay, a senior staff can do it with good knowledge of accounts. Okay, next. Bookkeeping mein kya hota hai? There is only journal and ledger. Whereas in accountancy, what it is there? It is P&L and balance sheet. Then period. Bookkeeping is on a daily basis, whereas accountancy is on a yearly basis. Okay, scope. Bookkeeping, since it's a shorter concept, so its scope is very limited, and accountancy, since it's a bigger concept than bookkeeping, so its scope is more broader, wider. Okay, bookkeeping में क्या क्या आता है? You follow, I mean, what is the basics of bookkeeping? You follow the basic principles of double entry system of bookkeeping. What is the double entry system of bookkeeping? That for every debit there is a equivalent credit. कोई भी transaction है, अगर उसका debit effect है, तो उसका equivalent credit effect भी होगा. तो this is what you learn in bookkeeping. Whereas accountancy में you don't learn debit credit, okay? Accountancy में what you learn to prepare financial statements. What are financial statements? That is, you learn to prepare P&L account, that is to estimate profit and losses, and you learn to know the financial position of the business through balance sheet. Okay, am I clear till here? मतलब जब बुककीपिंग का एप्लीकेशन खत्म हो जाता है तो अकाउंटेंसी का एप्लीकेशन शुरू होता है. समझ में आया? एक्नॉलेज इट इन द चैट बॉक्स, एक्नॉलेज इट इन द चैट बॉक्स. ओके फाइन. नेक्स्ट, लेट अस स्पीक अबाउट द प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ बुककीपिंग. बुककीपिंग में तो नॉर्मल प्रिंसिपल्स का, बुककीपिंग रिक्वायर्स प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ एलिमेंट्री नॉलेज ऑफ जर्नल एंड पोस्टिंग. मतलब अगर किसी को पता है कि नॉमिनल अकाउंट का रूल है डेबिट द एक्सपेंसेस क्रेडिट द इनकम. एनीबडी हु नोज द पर्सनल अकाउंट का रूल, ओके, डेबिट द व्हाट डू यू कॉल, डेबिट द रिसीवर एंड क्रेडिट द गिवर. एनीबडी हु नोज द रियल अकाउंट का रूल, डेबिट व्हाट कम्स इन क्रेडिट व्हाट गोज आउट. Can at least do the normal posting of journal into ledger. Okay, yeah. Whereas accounting mein you have to follow accounting principles. Okay, that is AS, accounting standards you have to follow. That is accountancy. Then bookkeeping records are used by accountants. Who are the users of bookkeeping? Only one person. That is your accountant of the company. And who is the user of accountancy? As I said it earlier, they are your owners, the owner of the company, the management, that is the board of directors of the company, the government, and one point you are missing is your bankers, जो आपको loan देते हैं, yeah, and your stockholders or your shareholders, okay? यहाँ तक समझा? Everybody understood the point of difference between bookkeeping and accountancy? Acknowledge it in the chat box. Did you all understand the point of difference between bookkeeping and accountancy? Okay, fine. Thank you. ठीक है. Now coming on to this, which I had done it in AS also. मैंने AS 1 में ये दो चीज आपको बताई थी. The cash basis and the accrual basis, where you we had learned about disclosure of accounting policies. Okay, yeah. So let me take you to the basis of accountancy. So there are two bases of accountancy India mein jo follow hota hai, wo ek hai cash basis aur ek hai mercantile basis. The mercantile basis is known as accrual basis. So cash basis mein kya hota hai? The policy of your company or the policy of your business is strictly on cash basis. मतलब आप उधार पे कुछ नहीं देते हो, ना लेते हो ना देते हो. ओके, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज कैश बेसिस. सो कैश बेसिस में ओनली कैश ट्रांजैक्शंस आर रिकॉर्डेड. ओके, कैश बेसिस एंड इनकम इज रिकॉर्डेड ओनली व्हेन कैश इज रिसीव एंड एक्सपेंसेस आर रिकॉर्डेड ओनली व्हेन द कैश इज पेड. तो जब मेरे पास पैसा आएगा, से फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ अ डेटर कॉल्स मी एंड से मैडम नहीं डेटर क्यों, डेटर होगा तो फिर कैश बेसिस आएगा ही नहीं. ओके, से कोई मेरे दुकान पे आता है मुझसे गुड्स खरीदने के लिए. ओके, द कस्टमर कम्स एंड ही टेक्स द गुड्स फ्रॉम मी. ही टेल्स मैडम मैं आप मुझे आज सामान दे दो, मैं कल लाके आपको पैसा देता हूँ, कल पैसा आपको दे दूँगा. नॉट अलाउड बिकॉज माई बिजनेस पॉलिसी इज वन कैश बेसिस नॉट क्रेडिट बेसिस. इज दैट क्लियर? हाँ, तो उसको मैं बोलूँगी कल आके सामान लेके जाओ, पैसा दे के जाओ. Like this. आज नहीं दूंगी उसको. Why? Because it is against my business policy. My business runs on the policy of cash basis. So when the chartered accountant comes to your company to audit your books of accounts, this is one of the disclosure you have to do. Okay, the accounting policy, that what are you following? It is it cash basis or it is accrual basis? Okay, right. So under cash basis, yeah, it's done. Business records every cash that comes in the business and every cash that goes out of the business. So this is purely a cash basis business transactions. Okay, then accrual basis mein kya hoga? Mercantile matlab agar tum mujhe bolte ho madam main abhi aapko 500 rupaye deta hu, baki ka 500 rupaye kal laake deta hu. I will sell him the goods. Yeah, leke jao अभी के अभी लेके जाओ, 500 रुपया लूंगी मैं हाफ कैश एंड बाकी का हाफ ही विल कम एंड गिव इट टू मी टुमारो एक्रूवल बेसिस. ओके, बिकॉज माय बिजनेस पॉलिसी इज कि मेरे इसमें उधार चलता है. कैश तो मोस्ट वेलकम, बट इसका ये मतलब नहीं कि कोई मुझे कैश देगा पूरा तो मैं नहीं लूँगी. एक्रूवल का मतलब वो नहीं होता है. इट विल एक्सेप्ट कैश एज वेल एज आउटस्टैंडिंग कैश. ओके, रिसीवेबल कैश भी कर दो. So an income is recorded when it is earned, whether cash received or not is not important. And expenses is recorded when they become payable, that is, it is paid or it is payable, doesn't matter. Accrual basis will come into picture. Both cash as well as credit transactions are recorded. Iska matlab ye hota hai under accrual system. Okay, see, I said na, it is known as the mercantile basis of accounting. The other name for accrual basis is mercantile basis. Okay, is it clear till here? Are you clear about the basis of accountancy? ठीक है. Next, branches of accounts. Now branches of accounts में there are three branches of accounts. Okay, now listen carefully. हाँ, there are three branches to accounts. One is financial accounting. Okay, financial accounting. Now this branch of account you are studying in semester 1, semester 2, semester 3, semester 4, semester 5, semester 6. So all your semesters, all the 3 years when you are in graduation, you will be studying about financial accounting. Okay, now come to cost accounting. Cost accounting is there in the last semester, that is semester 5 and 6. Management accounting. Management accounting is there only in the third semester. Matlab, when you go in the next year, you will study financial accounting plus MA. When you go in the third year, that is TY, you will study financial accounting and cost accounting and also one more branch of accounting called as taxation. But taxation is not considered as one of the branches. Jabki hona chahiye, tax is a part of accounting only. But aisa bolte hai ki jab aapka net profit aa jata hai, uske baad taxation shuru hota hai. Iske liye some people don't have that ideology of considering taxation in branch of accounting. So if you look, branch of accounting is divided only into three: financial accounting, cost accounting, and management accounting. Now financial accounting matlab where you are calculating net profit, net loss, and estimating the financial position of the business, that is called as financial accounting. Okay, see, it helps to see financial accounting is what? It ascertains profits and loss suffered during the year. Okay, and it also helps you to calculate. Ascertain means to calculate the financial position, that is balance sheet, on the date when the accounting period ends. So that is why, see, whenever you write P&L account, you write P&L account for the year ended, because it is the profits or the losses are estimate for the year. And when you write balance sheet as on a particular date. Matlab us din tumhara business ka position ye tha. Your financial position in the business was so and so thing. Okay, so that's financial accounting. Okay, now what is this cost accounting? Now what is cost accounting? I will help you understand with a small formula. आपने ये फॉर्मूला किया होगा अपने स्कूल डेज में, सी प्लस बी इक्वल टू एस, याद है सबको? मैथ्स में किया होगा, थर्ड फोर्थ स्टैंडर्ड में, याद है? जस्ट एक्नॉलेज इन द चैट बॉक्स, एवरीबडी रिमेंबर दिस फॉर्मूला, कॉस्ट प्लस प्रॉफिट इज इक्वल टू सेल्स, या कॉस्ट प्राइस प्लस प्रॉफिट इज इक्वल टू सेलिंग प्राइस. आई गेस एवरीबडी मस्ट बी नोइंग दिस फॉर्मूला. यस राइट ना? हाँ या वेरी गुड. ठीक है, तो जब हम प्रॉफिट निकालते हैं तो हम क्या कर रहे हैं? फाइनेंशियल अकाउंटिंग कर रहे हैं. और जब हम कॉस्ट प्राइस निकालते हैं, ओके, द ब्रांच ऑफ अकाउंटिंग व्हिच टीचेस अस हाउ टू कैलकुलेट कॉस्ट प्राइस, दैट इज कॉस्ट अकाउंटिंग. एम आई क्लियर? समझ में आया? द ब्रांच ऑफ अकाउंटिंग व्हिच टीचेस अस हाउ टू कैलकुलेट कॉस्ट एंड हैव अ कंट्रोल ओवर कॉस्ट is called as cost accounting. Okay, fine, clear? Okay, fine. ठीक है, चल मैं आपको एक example देती हूँ. Yeah, I'll give you an example. अभी suppose ये pen है जो मैं use कर रही हूँ. This is a pen which works on a touch screen laptop. Okay, so the laptop which I am having is a Microsoft ka Pro 6, Surface Pro 6 I am using. So ye pen isi pe chalta hai on this laptop. Theek hai? So the pen is also of obviously Microsoft. So the cost of the pen is 10,000. Okay, mere liye 10,000 hai. Mere ko to selling price pe mila hai. 10,000 ka ye pen hai. But do you really think when I am using C plus B equal to S, okay? So the company sold me the pen for 10,000. But do you really think the cost of the pen would be the same? Acknowledge it in the chat box. Cost of the pen for Microsoft is also same, 10,000. No, obviously not. है ना, Microsoft वाले ने क्या बोलते हैं, जगत खाता थोड़ी ना खोल रखा है कि 10,000 का पेन मुझे 10,000 में बेचेगा. No, this pen would be obviously less than 10,000. Okay, so say suppose Microsoft को ये पेन बनाने का कीमत माइक्रोसॉफ्ट का है से 6,000 रुपया. एंड आई होप यू ऑल नो माइक्रोसॉफ्ट एंड एप्पल दे आर एलीट प्रोडक्ट्स. तो ये लोग का प्रॉफिट मार्जिन बहुत हाई होता है. इनके कॉस्ट प्राइस इतने हाई नहीं होते और इनके जो प्रॉफिट मार्जिन होते हैं ये बहुत हाई होते हैं, बिकॉज दे नो द एंड यूजर्स ऑफ देयर प्रोडक्ट आर एलीट पीपल. ओके, पीपल हु आर ब्रांड कॉन्शियस, इनको पता है कि ये बहुत अच्छी चीज़ है. अगर मैंने आज जैसे ये ओके दिस पेन इज फॉर 10,000, तो आई नो इट्स अ कॉस्टली वन, बट आई नो व्हाट यूटिलिटी दिस पेन इज फॉर मी. मेरे लिए इसका यूटिलिटी बहुत है. तो ये पेन तो बाकी व्हाट यू कॉल इन अदर ब्रांड्स, इफ आई गो आई विल गेट दिस पेन फॉर लेसर अमाउंट, बट आई नो दिस ब्रांड इज द बेस्ट. तो ही नोज दैट द कस्टमर, द एंड यूजर्स ऑफ दिस पेन आर पीपल हु आर ब्रांड लॉयल टू माइक्रोसॉफ्ट, और से पीपल हु आर ब्रांड लॉयल टू एप्पल. Okay, see, even the Apple iPhones, if they are sold for lakh of rupees, 1.5, still the iPhone users who are brand loyal to iPhone, they purchase. Okay, yeah. So, isme profit margin bahut high hota hai. So, say 4,000 they are getting after every pen. So, 6,000 is their cost price. So, ye 6,000 kaise aaya? Microsoft has to justify. Okay, Microsoft has to justify this. तो देर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड एज कैस, कॉस्ट अकाउंटिंग स्टैंडर्ड्स. जब हम फाइनेंशियल अकाउंटिंग पढ़ते हैं तो द फर्स्ट चैप्टर वी लर्न वॉज अकाउंटिंग स्टैंडर्ड्स, ए एस, अकाउंटिंग स्टैंडर्ड्स बाई हुम? given by ICAI, Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. But when we study cost accounting के ऊपर कोई भी accounting standard नहीं follow होता है. Cost accounting का अपना accounting standards है, known as cost accounting standards, famously known as CAS, capital CAS. तो CAS 1 जो है, CAS 1 जो है, that talks about calculation of cost price. अभी समझ में आया? तो इंडिया में जितने भी मैन्युफैक्चरर्स हैं, जो भी गुड्स बनाते हैं, दे हैव टू फॉलो CAS 5, ओके, सॉरी CAS 1, दे हैव टू फॉलो CAS 1 टू कैलकुलेट कॉस्ट प्राइस. दैट इज हाउ दे जस्टिफाई द कैलकुलेशन ऑफ देयर कॉस्ट प्राइस. एंड व्हेन द कॉस्ट ऑडिटर और द चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट और द ICWA पीपल हु हैव डन ICWA, दे कम एंड ऑडिट योर बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स स्पेशली फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ कॉस्ट calculating your cost price, they will see what cost bifurcation you have given. Say Microsoft tells the cost auditor ki the pen ka jo bahar ka surface hai, it is made up of metal, metallic, that metallic hai. Pen ka jo lead hai, that is magnetic, okay, it has a magnetic lead, because of which it has that feather touch quality. The pen has a feather touch quality. You slightly touch on the screen, it will open all the required files you want. Okay, this plus iske andar machine, automated machines hai, because of which even if I am not opting out for the options on the screen, I can just press one side of the pen and the options will automatically appear on the screen. Okay, so it's a mechanized pen. So the all the latest mechanics are sink in to get this pen, and so you have to justify all in the cost price of the product. Am I clear? Samajh mein aaya, everyone? Acknowledge it in the chat box. Okay, so accounting standards hi nahi hai jo aap padhoge. There is something called as cost accounting standards jo ki aap padhoge. So jab aapne financial accounting kiya, when I did AS with you, I always keep telling you manufacturing of goods and services. Okay, yeah. तो ये जो मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ गुड्स है, दिस कम्स अंडर कॉस्ट अकाउंटिंग अंडर CAS 1. और ये जो मैन्युफैक्चरिंग ऑफ सर्विसेज है, इसका अलग से CAS है, CAS 5 है. ओके, तो देखो टर्मिनोलॉजीज के हिसाब से भी जरा अलग कॉस्ट अकाउंटिंग स्टैंडर्ड्स. फॉर गुड्स इट इज CAS 1 एंड फॉर सर्विसेज इट इज CAS 5. ओके, सो दिस इज कॉस्ट अकाउंटिंग. एनीवेज डोंट वरी, अभी पढ़ना नहीं है आपको, बाद में 2 साल के बाद पढ़ना है. होपफुली मैं ही पढ़ाऊंगी अगर तो, because I take this top chapter, I mean I teach this subject only in TYBCOM and TYBAS. Okay, and the last is management accounting. The last branch of accounting is management accounting. Okay, so management accounting kya hota hai? Now listen carefully, yeah? What is management accounting? Management accounting deals with sources of funds and application of funds. I repeat, management accounting deals with what? Sources of funds and application of funds. Okay? Yeah. Now, what is the sources of funds? Anyone wants to try? What is sources of funds? Kya hota hai? Funds kya hota hai? What is funds and what is sources of funds? Be quicker. I want to complete this part. Be quick. I want to complete this part. Equity, from where we can generate funds. Yeah, Vidhi, very good. Okay. Yeah, very good students. Good. Riya, Vaibhavi, Mehul. Yeah, yeah. Right. Shares, loans, debentures, bank. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Very good. ठीक है, अभी मेरी बात सुनो. Sources of funds मतलब जहां से पैसा आएगा. पैसा business में कैसे आएगा is known as sources of funds. I repeat, how will money pump inside the business? How will money come into the business is sources of funds. Sweet and short language, capital bolungi main isko. Okay, tumhare bookkeeping ke hisab se. So sources of funds, pehla sources of funds is through shares. Shares becho, paisa andar lao. Okay, the shareholder. Second sources of fund is bank se loan le lo. Loan le lo. Koi bhi loan le lo. Debenture loan le lo. Bank se loan le lo. Okay, like that. And third is reserves and surplus. Last year का profits पड़ा है तुम्हारे पास, use कर सकते हो ना ये साल as money, okay, for business. Yes, you can do that. So say for example, मेरा share capital है 5 lakhs, मेरा bank loan है 3 lakhs, मेरा लास्ट ईयर का रिजर्व्स एंड सरप्लस है 2 लाख, तो 5 + 3 + 2 कितना होता है 10 लाख. ओके, अब ये जो 10 लाख मेरे पास जमा हो गए जो मेरे बिजनेस में है, हाउ विल आई यूज दिस मनी इन बिजनेस, हाउ विल आई यूज दिस मनी, हाउ विल आई अप्लाई द फंड्स, हाउ विल आई यूज द मनी. सो आई विल यूज द मनी बाय परचेजिंग फिक्स्ड एसेट्स, से माय फिक्स्ड एसेट्स आर 4 लाख रुपीज. आई विल यूज द मनी बाय इन्वेस्टिंग इन अदर कंपनीज, ओके, इन लॉन्ग टर्म इन्वेस्टमेंट्स, से माय लॉन्ग टर्म इन्वेस्टमेंट्स इज 5 लाख, एंड आई विल कीप सम मनी 1 लाख रुपीज. तो हो गया ना 10 लाख, 4, 5, 9, 9 और 1, 10. तो ये जो 1 लाख है, दिस आई एम यूजिंग इट एज वर्किंग कैपिटल. तो वेयर एम आई अप्लाइंग, जो पैसा मेरे पास आया जो मैंने जमा किया 10 लाख, हाउ एम आई यूजिंग इट? आई एम फर्स्ट यूजिंग इट इन द परचेज ऑफ फिक्स्ड एसेट्स, सेकेंड इन लॉन्ग टर्म इन्वेस्टमेंट्स, एंड थर्ड वर्किंग कैपिटल. नाउ व्हाट इज दिस वर्किंग कैपिटल? Day to day business activities, buying and selling of goods, day to day business activity, business operation को चलाने के लिए we need hard cash, liquid money जिसको हम बोलते हैं, right? अभी जैसे if a worker comes to me and say, ma'am, I want 5,000 rupees for my house expenses, obviously I will pay him, he is my worker, right? हाँ, तो I तो what will I do? I will have cash with me, I will give it to him, or I will transfer to his account. आजकल तो बहुत जल्दी हो जाता है ना जीपे एंड एवरीथिंग में, राइट? मैं ऐसा नहीं उसको बोलूंगी अरे 2 दिन के बाद देती हूँ, मैं बैंक जाऊंगी पैसा लेके आऊंगी उसको दो. नो, तो वर्किंग कैपिटलिज्म में द मोस्ट लिक्विड कैश विच इज केप्ट विद यू फॉर रनिंग द डे टू डे एक्टिविटीज ऑफ द बिजनेस. एम आई क्लियर? दिस इज मैनेजमेंट अकाउंटिंग. इज इट